going on, everybody? It's Key Golden. I'm here with my guy, Jroc. We're here to talk about his paintings and his good drawings he's been doing. I've been keeping up with Jroc for a minute now, of course, through social media, but we've been talking back and forth, you know, just getting to know each other through social media, you know, supporting each other through that. And I just had to get the interview. I wanted to let you guys know and show you guys this coloring book he just dropped Monday. They are on sale. He's going to let you guys know the site and all of that. Before anything, you know, I got a couple questions for Jroc because I'm very interested in understanding and figuring out how he got so talented and why he's so embedded in the, you know, the art and how different that is, because a lot of things, you know, a lot of people aren't into that right now. Especially at our age, it's more of a music thing, or it's more of a, you know, I just feel like he's doing it so much different, in a different path, and I'm excited about getting to know him, getting these questions out. Jroc, my first question for you, how long have you been drawing and painting, and which do you prefer more? Do you like drawing, or do you like painting?
I've been drawing since the third grade. Who inspired me to draw? Like, I had two cousins that used to babysit me when I was about 6 or 7. And they used to draw like Dragon Ball Z characters and stuff now. And like, they were so talented, like how I am now. So I picked up a pencil and I tried to draw, and it was hard, you know, when you first learn how to write, mm-hmm. and hand shaking and stuff like that. So I just gave up. So nothing, you know, third grade rolled around. And in Tunk Elementary in Tunk, Mississippi, where we have the poster art contest, drill free poster art contest. And I'm not gonna lie, running around the neighborhood, I was like a little hustler. So it was like, on the intercom at school, that was like first place award get $100, second place get $50, and third place $25. Okay. And like, when I heard that $100 prize, I already knew in my head how I was gonna win. So I had went home, and my granddaddy took me to a Piggy Wiggy, a grocery store, and got a poster and some markers. And we went to my cousin's house, and I was telling her to draw my poster for me. So she drew these black stick figures holding drugs and standing on the cliff and jumping off a cliff into a lake of fire. And then we were like, stay drug free. Mm. And I took the poster to school the next morning, and they hung it on the wall. And like after lunchtime, the judges and stuff like that, they were judging the posters. And I just had a good feeling about that day, because like all the judges, all the teachers was just at my poster. And they was talking about it. And then they were going to announce the winners. And they did from third to second to first. Mm. And when they got the first, they were like, Jarvis Howard, first place. So, you know, me, I'm jumping in excitement. My teacher happy for me and stuff like that. And nothing, you know, it just got weird all of a sudden. And I see the judges, they just was looking at my poster and they were shaking their head. And me and my teacher just looking like, what they talking about? And they came to me and my teacher, and they was like, we sorry, we're going to have to disqualify Jarvis. I'm like, why? And then they was like, this poster is too advanced for third grade work. So they told me that I didn't do it, but actually I didn't. I got my cousin to do it, but my teacher, she was vouching for me. She was telling the judge, like, no, he was in the back of the class. He was in my class. He was working on the poster. And they disqualified me, and it like, killed my spirit that whole day. So I came to school the whole week sad. But it was something inside me, I don't know what it was. It's like my creativity and like my passion is far. So I just said, forget it. So I just came to school. Like after I finished my work, I asked my teacher, in third grade, you know, asked my teacher, can I go to the back of the class and draw, you know what I'm saying, on regular computer paper, draw on computer paper. And we went to the library and stuff like that. I was the only student like checking out cartoon books. And like, I got a draw from the cartoon books. I had a cartoon book right here that I was third grade rolled out, fourth grade came. Now, that's when I started drawing my classmates. It wasn't perfect, but it was all right. And I had the feel for drawing. Uh-huh. And fifth grade came. And, I had a teacher named Dolph. She was telling me, she was like, if you keep drawing in my class, I'm gonna fail you. But I had the passion for art then. Like, right. I didn't care, so I'm drawing. Fifth grade was over then. Summer came. My mom had to go get my progress report, and it had to show what I passed or not. And she went and got the progress report in the summer. Like, I ain't traveling, I passed. Then I looked at the progress report. It said you failed. So I was like, oh man. So then at the comment, it said, because you was drawing in my class. But they let me know right there was the passion. So fifth grade rolled around again because I failed.
Right.
Guess what I ended up doing? Okay. I had the passion for drawing. So I was drawing this graffiti wall, like with my neighborhood and stuff on it. And we were taking a test. I was drawing back of the test. I had a white teacher. She was pregnant at the time. And she came and ripped my drawing up. And knowing me, you know what I'm saying, kind of bad, running around the neighborhood and stuff like that. And when the class was like, ooh, and when the class said that, you know what I'm saying, you had to give them a show.
Right.
So I stamped up. I got the paper. And like before you know it, like I took ashes before I even know it. Nothing, you know, I threw the paper. And I hit the teacher in the head and I called out her name. I called her a B-word and she ran down the hall crying. When we got the principal, the police came, they were like, I got expelled, I had to go to another elementary. Then all of a sudden, 6th grade came, 6th, 7th, 8th grade came, all the contests, you know what I'm saying, what happened. It was over with from there. And 8th grade, one of my high school teachers, she came to the middle school, and 8th grade, she was like, you know you're drawing better than in the high school student.
Right.
When she told me that, they let me know that I had the vision for it, but people always was like, you can go somewhere, but you know, me being so young, I did not know that until like now.
Till now.
Yeah.
So would you say your cousins drawing Dragon Ball Z characters was your inspiration, biggest inspiration, or the things you went through elementary school?
I'm going to say what they did were like really inspired me from them drawing, being family, me being kicked out. And then kicked out of a grade,
right.
Being expelled from a contest, all those things really inspired me. Mm-hmm. Even through high school when I was drawing, I really never took art serious because I always heard, you can do this, you can do this. But not actually when I never started making money on art until like last year. So this was really, now really making me go hard. So
right.
At first it was just a hobby. Now it's a business.
It's a business.
Yeah.
That's what's up. I know I got into it about, I'll say a year ago. I think you followed each other about a year ago.
Yeah.
And been keeping up because that's when I started the radio station. And we just was supporting each other back and forth. And not gonna lie, I was like, dude, it's beyond, you know, beyond his age group. Like they were saying, this is advanced for even me. And then we get to what you draw when you ever, after this, he's gonna let you know what to find on social media. But what I was about to say is, when you see the way he, how particular he is in the characters he draws and the way, I don't know, he just puts so much care into it, and I can tell just from social media how much care, like he just said, he put in it from day to day, from over the years, just not getting paid for it, but still you constantly grinding, putting in work, and it is pretty amazing. My second question, what are your favorite supplies to use? Paints? Brushes, canvases. What do you prefer?
That's always a weird question because it's like I actually go what really be popping at the time. Like right now, color looks booming.
Mm-hmm.
So that means I'm gonna put paint to the side.
Okay.
But if someone requests a paint or something like that, I'll do it. But far as doing it, you know what I'm saying, for like free time, and then I'm not gonna do it because the color looks. I be promoting so much. You know,
right.
I promote basically whatever's booming at the time. If I do a graphic design or something that's going viral, mm-hmm. I keep creating more graphic design. If a paint going viral, I keep creating paints. Coloring books going viral, I keep doing coloring books. So basically, as I create more and more, I don't have to create every day. So I create, say for instance today, I make like 20 paints. These 20 paints going to allow me to, you know what I'm saying, to relax for like 3 weeks, you know, a whole month because.
Okay.
If people say I ain't working, I ain't got to do nothing. Oh, I drop another paint because I don't do nothing like one at a time.
Right.
Well, so basically, I work ahead of myself. So, you know what I'm saying? So I ain't got to stress myself out. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Trying to do this. So I just have a lot of stuff.
So is that stressful that people keep wanting it on demand like that? Is that stressful?
It is. Yeah, it is. But when you got the joy for it and you can knock something out like a logo or somebody text me like, I need a logo. Basically, I get them to sketch out their vision,
mm-hmm.
and I just put my artistic skills to it.
Right.
Somebody want a paint, knock it out, couple hours. A graphic design, couple hours. A paint on a hat, couple hours.
Ooh.
Simple. Like, it's just me putting in the work behind the scenes is really allowing me to, you know what I'm saying, to knock out stuff really quick.
Right. Yeah. What part of drawing or painting do you enjoy more? Is it the feedback? Process, or is it the finished product? Is it the people wanting on demand that you like the most, or is it the process that make you? Because me and Blake, we talked about how humble you are, which is amazing. Because like I was telling my artist last Friday, being humble has the pros and cons, because I'm that way. And it's like, sometimes people make you be a dog, because it's like, you know, yeah. give me my credit. It's not that you need the credit, it's just like, dang, you know what I'm saying? So what is it, the demand that, you know, that make you go hard, or is it just, or is it the process?
It's all of the above, but I think the feedback is what's most crazy to me. It's like I was telling you earlier before the interview, like when people tell me, hey bro, you the GOAT, man, you inspired me, you this and this. And I always think that where I'm from, it's not where you're from, it's where you're at, but to go from a small town to have your work in different cities, you can't beat that. But the most thing about feedback is when other inspiring artists just trying to come up in your footsteps, and they try to ask you got any advice? Not always give an unanswered to the people that's trying to do art. I've been letting people know that I do art now. Like, this is how I eat. I must create in order to provide. And when I have a family, this is the way I'm going to have to provide. So me approaching art and you approaching art might be a totally different thing. Because you might try, you know what I'm saying? If somebody hit me up and be like, I want to learn how to draw, people probably just trying to learn how to draw just to say they know how to draw. Mm-hmm. Or, you know what I'm saying, just to draw. But me, on the other hand, like I that's why I promote like crazy, and like my work ethic is so serious, because this is how I eat. And I was just trying to tell all other artists, just draw every day. But I can't tell you the way I came up, because if you try to take the same footsteps, you might not
get the same result.
Like, I got a huge social media following, and like I got a lot of cousins that rap and photography. I try to break down to people why I don't do shout outs, because I'm trying to tell people my fan base is based on me, and they see my struggles to my success. So just because I shout you out, or like say if somebody still follow all the people I'm following, just because they support me the way they support me, they might not support you the same way they support me, because people are seeing me, you know what I'm saying, put the work in.
Right.
I'm trying to tell them, you have to get your own fan base so they can know. Like, say for instance, you just come out the blue and you get a certified chick, and they be like, hold on, like, where did you come from? But when they see you, the struggles, and you still posting, and you still getting better and better.
Right.
Yeah, that's an amazing feeling, like, to see your fans. When you post something good, they be like, I remember. And you ain't, well, nobody was missing when you,
exactly.
I remember this.
Exactly.
You can't be through
it. I mean, call me the GOAT and things like that. I'm not going to say I don't like it, but I kind of push away from it, because I'm like, I haven't got where I want to be at all. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I'm just starting, like you said, I went from the beginning through the struggle to get where I am now. So I can't even say I'm the GOAT, because I'm not even where I want to be yet. So I truly understand it. I still want to get the question out of you. Drawing or painting, which one? Which part is the best for you?
To be honest, I done put so much work in every craft that I'm not trying to brag on them, but it's easy now. Mm-hmm. Like, you won't even believe. Okay, when I came to the University of Memphis, the only thing I knew how to do was draw sketches. But when I took the time out to learn how to do graphic design, it boosted me up on another level. I learned how to do graphic design last year. I've been riding my friend's truck. He had some hats, and he was going to throw them away. I was like, nah, bro, don't throw the hats away here. And he was like, which one do you have? I was like, man, we should paint them. He was like, you ain't never painted for them. Last November was my first day ever painting on some hats, and it was amazing. And we did a photo shoot for hats the same day. So last year was the first year I learned how to do graphic design and learned how to paint.
There's no way. Cause I was just about to say, I remember you dropping those, and they were amazing.
Yeah, they were my first day painting in my life.
What? So all those paintings from November to now, you just learned how to paint those?
Yeah.
What?
And the funny thing is, in November when I painted, them just hats. I wasn't painting on canvases. Right. I didn't even know how to do it. Like, my friend was like, bro, paint on canvas. I'm like, I can't do it. But when I did it, it was all right. But as I did it more, it was over with. After when January hit of 2018, then it rolled around, keep going, unstoppable. All in 1 year.
It's blessings. Yeah, God is real. Want y'all to know that officially.
Yeah, I want to add.
You not knowing it.
What? The pros and cons about an artist, though, like for me, I kind of hate is like my mind breaks everything down. As in a drawing perspective, like now I can look at this landscape and I can break it down as a blueprint. Like now, like I know how the paint gonna look before I paint it.
Right.
Like I know how this was gonna look before I did the graphic design work. So it's like my mind, like a laser printer, it got the layout, but I just have to do the work. So that's why they were like, Do you care about messing up? I don't care about messing up because my eyes can see every mistake and I can fix that mistake. So that it's kind of scary, but it's good at the same time because everything you look at is like, and you see stuff popping out. I'm like, bro, what? Like my mind think like that because I draw, paint, and do graphic design so much.
Right.
It's just how good my creativity level is.
But that just means you're perfecting your craft, though. Then the fact that you're saying it's easy is you just perfecting your craft to the utmost. Because when you said, you know, you can see it before you even draw it out, is amazing. Because I was thinking, I try to do that with my beats. I produce and I try to, like, harmonize or hum what I have in my head so that I can put it out. Because that's the hardest part, is to put it out on the track. And like you said, that's amazing. It's just perfecting your craft. So I feel like now, when I get to that point where I can flow, I can make a beat in 5-10 minutes, I feel like, okay, I'm perfecting my craft to the utmost. Because right now, it probably takes me a good 20-30 minutes to make a beat.
Yeah.
When I feel like I can do it in 5-10, you know, then I feel like I'm somewhere. Like, but that's amazing, though, y'all. Blessings on blessings.
Do you, when you make beats, do you... When somebody like, oh my God, that beat is so amazing, and you be like, it's all right.
Yeah.
But like when, like, say for instance, when you tell me this color book of art, all right, I'll be like, it's all right. But deep in my heart, I know it's good, but I have to remain humble to let people know it's all
right.
Because these color books, you know what I'm saying, they sound cool enough. But the thing is, I always work as, okay, you got these color books. My mind be thinking, okay, bro, you got the color moves out. What's next? After I dropped it, people going crazy over that. Just feel like, I'm like, okay, bro, they doing it. What's next? Like, okay, you got these out. What's next? You know what I'm saying? Like, everything you do, you always got to have, okay, what's next? Because this is going to circulate for a certain amount of time. Bro. You got to have, as soon as you get tired of this, drop something else.
Right.
Drop something else. Drop.
Right.
So you're not staying relevant is basically those. Consistent and staying relevant is those. Staying humble. Taking
it
so far.
Jarvis is dropping jewels right now. I'm taking it all in because we the same age, and I'm just thinking, like, I can just feel how both of our minds are a little bit older than our age, and I love it. I'm just glad that you are invested in something that's productive because it's, you know, it's spreading to other people our age, and it's crazy how his color books are selling like this to 20-year-olds, 21-year-olds, 22-year-olds. That is crazy. He's been eating lately. You just heard him. He's only been painting since November, but drawing since the third grade, and it's only been getting better for him. I just honestly can say it's just blessings. Not to say, you know, not to say that, like you said, staying relevant is most important.
Oh, yeah.
Like I was saying about my music, like when somebody do say, oh, it's all right, sometimes I do feel like, yeah, that turn is honestly hard, but maybe it could be critiqued. Like you said, just keep jumping on top of things is important. I really felt that. I just love these jewels that Jarvis dropping. My last question I want to know is, what inspires your color? Before that, I want to know, what is your favorite 90s memory before we even get into it? Okay, before that, I'm going to tell y'all mine, if I can't look inside, huh? I don't want to cheat and look inside the book. I'm a 90s, I want to say Tommy Pickles or Penny Proud. Now I'm going to throw it on Jarvis.
Okay,
I'm rocking with it.
You won't even believe, I'm 24 years old. I still watch Toy Story 23. Like it ain't nothing. Like, that's my show, though.
Right.
That's my show.
Okay, yeah, I got it from Toy Story. Woody, Buzz Lightyear.
Yep.
Go ahead.
The Springy Dog, the Potato Head, Mr. Potato Head, T-Rex, the Pig. All
of them. Andy, don't forget Andy. Don't ever forget Andy.
One name to the bad boy,
See it.
Yeah,
shout out to the 90s and 2000s. That was our prime. So shout out to those times. We had a good time. So what inspired the 90s coloring book we got right here? I'm gonna open it up a little bit. Y'all need to check them out. This man got.
You won't even believe.
Come on now, The first page, Arnold. And I know y'all remember that. And I know you remember Cat and Dog. I'm not going to go through the whole thing. This is just a snippet of how good Jarvis is with this pencil. Like, come on, y'all. What inspired this color book? What inspired the 90s part?
ever seen in class last year. That's way too far behind the representative. And I just was in class, I don't know what name it had, but I looked at the board and I see the paper. I was throwing sponge bomb. That was the perfect sponge bomb I ever seen. Some said, my man was like, drop that to this ass sponge bomb. I drew sponge bomb smaller. I mean, I drew Patrick's sponge bomb, size sponge bomb right. Body. Bro, you just threw out the curtain to the size one ball. So I threw out the curtain to the size one ball. I was like, hold on. When I did it, I did another curtain from another show. And all the ideas, I'm like, hold on, that's fine. But I had this, not a mentor, but my friend, he's like, Big City, he's a photographer in Memphis. My well-known photographer, Impact Life. He was like, bro, let me see that design. So he got it. He put it on the computer, and he made it into a graphic like this, a graphic design. He sent it to my phone, like, ain't no way. It was amazing. But I didn't know how to do graphic design because it was so amazing to me. So he was like, bro, we need to do something with these. I was like, what are you thinking? And I just looked at one down, like, bro, what you think about the coloring book? He shook my hands, and that's it. But I prolonged the coloring book so long for like a year. Like, over this summer, I had some thinking to do. So, like, bro, you've been stressing, you've been, you know what I'm saying? Having little struggles, I was like, you need to do something to have people going crazy. Some said, when you come back to school, bro, drop the color. And I dropped the color books on Labor Day.
Them jumps are going crazy, y'all. Crazy. Jarvis, where can we find the color books?
You can go to my Facebook, my Instagram, my Twitter, and even on my Snapchat. I had a link in my bio, but the books is on Etsy.com. You ever heard of Etsy?
Etsy.com. Yeah.
And you just type in Honey Baby Coloring Book and it'll go straight to my page. $10, $5 shipping.
What's the social media?
All my social media is at Jroc Jarvis. JROCJARVIS. And you can find me on there. I'm not bougie. I'm not big headed or nothing. I'm going to follow you back. You DM me. You want to know about my life, my need, any inspiration, advice, anything. I promise you, I'm going to get to you and I'm a real deal. Give my heart to anybody that reach out for real.
Yeah, shout out to Jarvis Key Golden, Jarvis Howard, y'all heard it. This has been a very inspirational interview. I'm so thankful that we got this in the books because, like I said, for us to be in our prime, in our 20s, you know, to be so inspiring and to be chasing something so, I know it's important to Jarvis, but just to be chasing something so different. You know what I'm saying? It's different. I love that. And I think for us to be in our prime, we got to keep going. Like Jarvis was saying, got to keep grinding. Don't give up because things only going to be better. And my guy has been receiving nothing but blessings, y'all. And I also want to thank Jarvis for just sitting down with me, letting me come down campus with him, just chat with him a little bit, get to know him a little bit. It's been amazing. It's been fun. Jarvis, anything else you want to say?
I promise I got a little bit to say. Last but not least, man, I would love to say I would shout out to Key Golden for the interview. Hey, she doing her thing, you know what I'm saying? Keep doing your thing. I just want to tell you, just stay humble. And when you down, you always remember where you come from. So you look back. Like for me, for instance, when I'm in school, I know the circumstances I go back to. Do I want to go struggle? Or you gonna come to school and grind your butt off? Not even if I'm dropping good art. I'm putting in work in the classroom. So if people look and say I ain't doing my thing, my grades good and art good, humble and positive.
Can't go wrong.
Can't go wrong. And I want to say this too. What really inspired me to go so hard to this day, even if I'm doing good art, I just want to show all the young black kids in these neighborhoods, man, that even the women, like, you don't have to play sports to make it out. Like, you can really be the president of the United States. You can live your dreams. And, like, that's why when I get older, I want to tell my kids, I kind of fell victim to it, but I got out of it because if you got 80-year-old men and 50-year-old men standing on the block, we're going to think that's cool because we the people that look up to you, man. But we never had nobody in our neighborhood tell us, hey, bro, hey, sis, if you go to school, you can do anything you want to. We never heard that.
Right.
But I'll go, me and you see, we can be the future to change it. So
right.
I just want to let everybody know that, man, you can do anything you want to do. My art is just my way of showing it. Like, man, you can.
We're trying to do nothing but inspire out here, like we said, in our prime. We're trying to do nothing but show these young men and women, even girls and boys, you can do sports to all your other passions and just grind at it. Like Jarvis said, as long as you grind, you got it. As long as you praying, you got it. So Key Golden, Jarvis Howard, I want to thank everybody for tuning in. And like you said, Jroc, at Jroc Jarvis everywhere. Go get this coloring book, 90s baby coloring book. Deuces.
Astro. Yeah. Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know.